are going to create a footprint for the shutdown controller. The part number of this component is TPS64200. Okay, so this is the step down controller, and the package name is SOT-23. This is the package name. Okay, and this is the SMD footprint. So we are going to search the package outlines in the data sheet. So first we have to search where is the package outline data. So here you can get it. This is the assembly drawing they have given. This is the recommended layout pattern they have given. So to create any footprint, first we have to create a pads. It is there in Allegro. To create any footprints, first we have to create the pad. So before starting the footprint, we have to create the pad. So pad dimensions they have given here. It is the pad width they have given 0.1 mm. 6x they have given means this same pad 6 times is there. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pads are with same information, same dimensions. So we will create only one pad and we'll place it 6 times. Okay, so the height of the component they have given, height of the pad they have given 0.6 mm, width of the pad they have given 1.1 mm. So same thing we have to create in our Allegro pad designer. So how to create Allegro assembly footprints in Allegro pad designer, I will show you one by one step. Okay, so first we have to click on Allegro pad designer, it is open. Then we have to provide the name. Then so we are going to create the give the name. So file, then new, then provide the name right here, R060_110. Why? Firstly, I have told you whatever dimensions are there for footprint or for pads, we have to write in 100 multiple form. Okay, 100 multiple form. How it is? Means given data, given information, or given dimensions into 100, then you will get this. Okay, so that they have given the height of the component 0.6 mm. So I have multiplied it 100, so I got 60. And 0.110 they have given the width of the pad. So I have 110 into 100, I have got 110. So then after this we have to browse this folder where you want to keep. So I want to keep in footprint folder only, so I am just clicking on open. Okay, now this folder naming convention has been done. Now what we have to do, the first step is to change the unit. It is default, it is in mil, so just change it in millimeter. Okay, right here this one 0.3. now go to the layer tab, click on single layer mode. Why we have to check it the single layer mode? Because we are working for the SMD pad. Okay, so for SMD pad we have to click on single layer mode. For through hole pads we don't need to check all the thing, check the single layer mode. Okay, so for SMD only we have to check this mode. And for SMD footprint creation we required only three information required. Top begin layer data dimensions we required, shoulder mass top and face mass top. This only three required. First begin layer, then shoulder mass top, and then face mass top. Three data only required. So what the things I have written, we have to write. So I have made a note for it. See, I have made, please write this within process in your notebook and read it carefully. So I will explain how I have done. So we have to open this pad designer. Okay, next step is go to the file menu and you provide the name of the pad what I have done previously, and browse folder, click open and okay. Now second step is change the unit, which is we have done already. This one point we have given 2. Now take the single layer mode, we have taken already. Take the single layer mode. Now click the begin layer, and we have to fill that information. Okay, so how we have to fill, I'll tell you one by one. See, go to the begin layer. Okay, select here a rectangle, right here what is the width in our data sheets. Width they have given 1.1 mm. Okay, same thing right here, width 1.1 mm. Height they have given 0.6 mm. You can verify it. See, height of the pad they have given 0.6 mm, so I have given the same. Now we have to go the solder mask top. The rule of the solder mask top ki the given dimensions of the regular pad plus 6 mil in height and 6 mil in width. So here I am going to provide you the information. The regular pad we have already drawn, we have given already filled the data. Solder mask top we have to calculate and we have to write this. So I have already calculated this, so you can have a look on it. Please have a look on this. So same thing I'm going to fill in my this in the solder mask top. So first we have to click on rectangle, check, we have to browse rectangle. Now width, how much width we have to provide? 1.25 width, and height we have to provide, .75 mm. How? 0.6 plus 0.15. okay, and the last one is face mask top. So face mask top information is just same as the begin layer, means what the actual pad size they are given. Same thing we have to write in face mask top also. So go to the rectangle, go to the blue pad and change the rectangle. Width is how much? 1.1 mm. Height they are given 0.6 mm. Okay, it is reflecting here. Putting it now, file, save, it is saved. Now we have to check, R060_110 pad is created or not. So go to the physical verification for I will check my folder. So footprint have kept here, footprint. See, our successful. It is clicked. Now, what we'll do? We'll go for the next.